Welcome to SAP Developer News. I'm Ian Thane, and this is your weekly update.
The July release for SAP Continuous Integration and Delivery Service is out now. There are new build options for CAP projects. There's support now for GitLab in addition to GitHub and Bitbucket. And the service is now also available in the AWS data center in Japan. In addition, there's more documentation and tutorial content, including this tutorial that takes you through running a pipeline for a CAP project. And last but not least, this service is available on the free tier plan on Business Technology Platform. Check out the blog post for more information and give the tutorial a spin.
This week, we release an update to the SAP HANA Developer Command Line Interface sample. This particular sample has long served as both an example of how to build command line tooling that can interact with SAP HANA, but also as a reusable tool with features specifically designed for developers working on SAP HANA systems. But this latest update focuses on something that might at first seem a bit unusual for a command line interface. And maybe I'm going to break some rules here, but we've basically added a browser-based graphical user interface to do some of the commands. Now, don't worry, all the command line functionality is still there, and all the commands can still be scripted as well. The entire tool can also still be installed via Node Package Manager and ran directly from development environments like the SAP Business Application Studio or Visual Studio Code. However, we wanted to simplify the experience for some of the more robust commands that had numerous options and parameters. This approach allowed us to also add type-ahead suggest values and further support documentation within the tool. This makes commands like the mass convert command more accessible to first-time users or those only interested in the tooling to help move to HDI, CAP, or HANA Cloud. All the command execution still happens in the CLI process. We just run a temporary web server from within that process using Node.js Express, and then spawn a browser window to connect to it. No application server deployment or web hosting is needed. The commands still execute in the CLI process, and they just stream their output that would normally go to the console instead to the web browser using WebSockets. So regardless of if you were only interested in the solution to streamline your HANA migrations or daily development, or if you want to learn how to integrate SAP UI5 interfaces into your own command line utility, this is a code sample we'd recommend you check out.
Hi, everyone. My name is Menina Chow, and I'm a community advocate for the SAP Analytics Cloud topic on SAP Community. I'm here to tell you a little bit more about it, how we support it on SAP Community, and where you can go to find more information. Now, SAP Analytics Cloud is a single solution, business intelligence, and enterprise planning. It's augmented with the power of artificial intelligence, machine learning technology, and predictive analytics. It helps everyone in your organization to make better decisions and act with confidence. Now, there are plenty of resources on SAP Community. Let's start with the main topic page. This is where you will find latest product updates, upcoming events such as community calls, or learning resources for you to get started or deep dive into the topic. Go to the blogging area and read what other community members write about this topic. Follow the tags related to SAP Analytics Cloud and get involved with Q&A. Ask your own questions or answer those of others. See you in SAP Community.